Good morning, students. Today we'll learn something about auxiliary verbs. All right. So in our page number 119, we have one column of learning about language. In this very column, we have one term that is auxiliary verbs. Alright, so let's start our topics from auxiliary verbs. First of all, we have to know what is an auxiliary verb. Alright, so students, verbs are many. Alright, and some small verbs also we are getting in the sentence, and some main verb, or we can say some verbs are there which is telling something of some other verb in the sentence, isn't it? Like that only some verbs are there which used to help the main verb in the sentence. Those are known as our helping verbs or our auxiliary verbs. That's why here you might have been seen on the board, you can see there, auxiliary means helping. Alright, here it is given, auxiliary means helping. So one new point we came to learn today, that auxiliary verbs are those verbs which helps other verbs. Their verb is to help. To the other verb in the sentence. Now which type of verb they will help? They are helping the main verb in the same sentence. That type of verbs are known as our auxiliary verbs. Their verbs are there and their verb is to help other verbs or the main verb in a sentence. That's why auxiliary verbs are known as our helping verbs. Clear? Now, for our auxiliary verb, some examples are given. Let's see that. For example, here it is written, has formed. Alright? Next is our, will be walking. Again, next one, shall have been walking. So students, one thing to notice here, the first example, walk is our main verb and has is our auxiliary verb. Alright, in the same way, walking is our main verb and will be is our auxiliary verb. Alright. Now here, walking is our main verb and shall have been is our auxiliary verb. So, one thing is clear by seeing these examples that it is not necessary for the verbs which belong to our auxiliary verbs that there should be only one verb. No, here is one, but here is not one, here is two, and the same one, two, three verbs are there. So it is clear by these examples that auxiliary verbs are of one word also and more than one word. It can be. It is not the rule that in our auxiliary verbs will get only one word or one verb. No, it can be one and more than one. It can be a single word or it can be a group of words which belong to our auxiliary verbs. and it is already clear by seeing these examples, isn't it? So students, for our auxiliary verbs, we can say that auxiliary verbs are of many kinds, or it can be used in many ways. Right? It can be used in many ways. Means one word we are getting there. It is not the thing that it is alone. It can't help others. No. Auxiliary verb can be a single word, and auxiliary verb can be a group of word too. Alright. So according to the example, we got one word here, two word, and more than two word. It is clear that auxiliary verb is not only one word; it can be a group of words. Clear? Now the second point I want to tell you all in this example, whatever the examples are given, all in our positive form we are seeing. It can be negative also by using the word not. Let's see that. Has not got. The word not indicates that it is our, which type of auxiliary verb? Auxiliary verb is there, but it is in the negative form. So has not is our auxiliary verb, which indicates the negative form. Alright, same like that, will not be walking. Here is our main verb, and will not be is our auxiliary verb. It is in the negative. Alright, now here, shall have not been walking. Walking is our main verb, and shall have not been is our, here in this group, shall have not been is our negative form. Alright, so two sides you got, positive and negative. It is not the thing that in between you will get not, then you will think that it is not our auxiliary verb. No. If that is yes, then one side no should be there. Or both sides when you will get, then the verb will be done. Isn't it? Positive, then negative. Yes, then no. So like that. Example of positive we got, and some examples of negative is there. Alright? After that, what it is said? Not only these, some more auxiliary verbs are there, such as has, will, is, will be, shall, have, were, been, are. So and so forth. Many words you can get for your auxiliary verbs. Alright? But those auxiliary verbs, the word is what? They will have to help the main verb in the sentence. Alright? Now, after these examples, let's see what it is given. After that, one exercise is given for us to solve. So we have to work out. First of all, let's see what it is asking, or which work we have to do. Alright? Here it is telling, pick out the auxiliary verbs in the following. We have to pick out the auxiliary verbs which are given in these sentences. Alright? So, what word will work out today? We have to pick out the auxiliary verbs. Alright? We have to select the auxiliary verbs. We have to choose the auxiliary verbs from these all sentences today for our work, and get our work done. Alright? So, let's start our work. Come to sentence number 1. The boy is talking. Alright? The boy is talking. In this sentence, if we will not write is, then which word will get? The boy talking. The full meaning we are getting of the sentence? No. Some words are missing. According to the tense, it is our present tense one form. That sentence is of present tense. Is of present continuous. The boy talking. Some words are missing or complete meaning we are not getting. So, if we are forming the sentence in present continuous, then is will get. If we are forming in past continuous, then in the place of is will get was. Isn't it? If we are writing the sentence belonging to our future continuous, then in this place, in the place of is will get will be. So, the use of auxiliary verbs are very necessary to form a sentence to give us complete meaning or sense. Alright, as I told you just now. So, students, here in number 1, the sentence is written. The boy is talking. From this sentence, what we have to do? We have to search the auxiliary verbs. First of all, to work out, let's search where is our main verb. Alright? The boy is talking. Talking is our main verb. And the word is helping the main verb talking. So the word is our auxiliary verb. Alright? Sentence number 1 is over. Now step into sentence number 2. They are going home on Monday. In this sentence, going is our main verb and the word are is our auxiliary verb. So, we got are as our auxiliary verb in sentence number 2. Alright? Now, come to sentence number 3. We will be taking a taxi to the station. Let's search our main verb. They will be taking. Taking is our main verb. And the word will be is our auxiliary verb. Alright? So students, in our sentence number 3, we got two words. One. Isn't it? This? One and two. This is not a single word. Two words are there. And it is our auxiliary verb. Alright? Now, come to our sentence number 4. They have not seen each other for 2 years. In our sentence number 4, what we'll do? First of all, we have to search the main verb. Main verb is seen. Yeah, seen. And the word have not is our auxiliary verb. In which form? In negative form. Alright? So, sentence number 4 is solved. Now come to sentence number 5. In our sentence number 5, it is written, Pradeep was singing and his sisters were dancing. So, two parts are there. In our sentence number 5, two parts of the sentence and both the parts are joined with the word and to make a single sentence. So, two parts are there. Then, two main verb will get. Along with that, two auxiliary verbs we have to search. Alright? So, let's do that. Verb over here. Pradeep was singing. Singing is our main verb and was is our auxiliary verb. First part is over. Now second part. His sisters were dancing. Dancing is our main verb and verb is our auxiliary verb. So students, in sentence number 5 we got 2 main verb and 2 auxiliary verbs. Alright. Now sentence number 6. Never have I seen such a horrible sight. It is telling some surprising thing. Never have I seen such a horrible sight. So, this sentence number 6, is telling some surprising things. And due to exclamation mark, we came to know that this sentence is our exclamatory sentence. So, starting is given, never have I seen such a horrible sight. Means, I have never seen such a horrible sight. So the neighbor is also our negative. Isn't it? So we got here, first of all, what we have to do? We have to search where is our main verb. Seen is our main verb and have we are in. With have, neighbor indicates the negative. So, never have is our auxiliary verb. Now, students, this type of sentence very rarely we are getting. Alright. So, the word never is used to express any surprising things. To express our feelings in a surprising way, amazing way. That time, the word never we are using. Alright. And it indicates the negative part. Never have is our auxiliary verb and your seen is our main verb. Alright. So, seen we got as our main and never have we got as our auxiliary verb. Never and this exclamation mark whenever we will get or we will see in the sentence and it will be asked to work out for our auxiliary verbs. We have to remember students that the never word or the word never is used to express any surprise. Alright? And it also belongs to our auxiliary verb. Clear? Now, come to the next sentence, that is sentence number 7. By Tuesday, we will have been waiting 6 days for his reply. It is a long sentence. Isn't it? Again. By Tuesday, we will have been waiting 6 days for his reply. Let's search where is our main verb. In this sentence, main verb is here, waiting. Waiting is our main verb. Alright? Then the words here, will have been is our auxiliary verb. Altogether, 3 words. Alright? In sentence number 7, waiting is our main verb. Okay, and we got will have been as our auxiliary verb. So we have solved this exercise. We got some main verb and some auxiliary verbs in the same sentence to help the main verb. Isn't it? So students, a small point we have to remember that auxiliary verbs are our helping verbs. To whom they are helping? They are helping the main verb in the sentence. In which sentence? In the same sentence. Alright? And it is not necessary that only one word belong to auxiliary verb. It is not like that. There can be a one word, there can be more than one word. Alright? There can be one word, there can be a group of words. Only we have to learn or keep on remembering that which type of words can be our auxiliary verbs. And those verbs or the auxiliary verbs we can get in our examples. Isn't it? And which is our main verb? The column of verbs, that is verb 1, verb 2, verb 3, verb 4, verb 5, like that columns. You might have to see the first column, that is V1. That column, whatever verbs are there, those are our main verbs. In that only we are adding ED or some changes are going on till our verb 5, isn't it? That's why here some ING, we got some ED words we got. So, in brief, for today's learning, we learned something about our auxiliary verbs. Alright? A small thing we have to remember, auxiliary means to help. Okay? What do they help? They help the main verb in the sentence. So, it is easy for us to search that in a sentence where is our auxiliary verbs according to the examples we already we have already seen and we have worked out. If you will remember the examples of auxiliary verb, it will be very easy for you to solve such a work or such an exercise, isn't it? So students, till then, keep on learning. Take care. Thank you.